The Onefinity CNC machine is a versatile, powerful tool that you can use to customize any woodworking project in your shop. Today I'm going to talk to you about the five essential bits you need to get started. Buy these at the same time you buy the machine. If you're ready to unlock the full potential of your machine, this video is for you. The first bit is a flattening bit. You're going to need this when you're setting up your machine because you're going to need to flatten your spoil board, your waste board, which is this right here. But MDF is very wavy from the factory. It doesn't come flat. It looks flat when you're on a machine, when you're on at Lowe's and you're looking at it, it looks flat, but it's not. It's got a very slight wave to it, maybe one side or the other, undetectable to your eye. But when you're dealing with hundreds of inches, that makes a big difference on your engraving. This is a SPI tool, and I'm going to leave a link in the description below so you can buy the exact bit I use. I like this bit because it's adjustable and you can replace the cutters on it. See these little screws? The next bit I want to talk to you about is the V-carve bit. The V-carve bit is used to cut intricate engravings into your project. It has several blades that are angled at 90 degrees. This allows you to provide angled and repeatable results in your carving. I'll leave a link in the description below of the exact bit that I use. The next bit I want to talk to you about is the spiral end mill. You can see here, as I turn it, it's a spiral. Now this is also a compression bit. You can see there's like two cutters on every single flute. These come in up spirals and down spirals. And all that means is the direction you're pushing the material. So if you're doing a pocket, you're gonna want an up spiral. So as the bit turns, removing material, it's pulling the material up towards your dust collector. The spiral shape is perfect for any hardwood operation and it reduces chatter and vibration. You can use the spiral end mill to make intricate shapes and perfect pockets. This cutter is so versatile, this should be the second bit you buy. It works on wood, aluminum, or plastic, and they come in multiple diameters, 1/4 inch, 1/8 inch, 1/16 of an inch, but they start to get a little delicate around there and it's very easy to snap a bit. I like the 1/4 inch because even though it wastes a little bit of material, it's a really sturdy bit. Now the next bit is for plywood or melamine, anything that is got layered panels or particle board in it. It's a straight flute. Now if you notice on the very top, it has a V pattern. The V pattern allows it to plunge into the plywood and you can see the difference between the flat bit and the spiral bit here. This won't work well on plywood because if you're pulling the material up, you're going to actually get a lot of splinters along the edge of your plywood, which is why the straight flute makes much more sense for plywood. It also makes a very smooth finish on the plywood. I have to say, I cut out a bunch of Valentines for my son's preschool, and I used this on 5mm plywood, and they needed very little sanding. I mean, just a touch. The last bit of the five essential bits I want to talk to you about today is the bowl bit. You don't need to buy this right away to get started with the CNC, but this is what's gonna make making pockets much easier. You see how it's shaped? Mine's really dirty because I use it a lot. But this is a 3/4 inch bit with a 1/4 inch round over. So it creates a very nice pocket with rounded edges on the inside, which serves two purposes. The first is it looks nice. It's not a right angle at the bottom of your ring dish. And also when you have to sand all the little marks that are left inside, you can actually just use the contour of your finger in order to sand it. You don't need to get in there really tight with, you know, magnifiers into the corner. And lastly, I'm gonna put a link to this in the description below. They are affiliate links. I make a couple pennies if you buy one off Amazon. I thank you for your support. It doesn't cost you anything extra. So if you can use the links below, I'd really appreciate it. And all five of these bits that I use personally, that I love over and over again, are in the description below. So to recap, The five bits that are most important are the flattening bit, because this is going to allow you to flatten your wasteboard so you can start using your machine. So that's a no-brainer. The next class of bits are cutters. These are your end mills. This one is a spiral bit for hardwood, and this one straight flute for cutting plywood and melamine. These are engraving bits, 60 degree and 90 degree. This is for doing intricate design work inside on hardwood or plywood. And this is a bowl bit. This is what's going to give you a really nice contoured pocket. Thank you so much for watching this video on the five essential CNC router bits for your Onefinity CNC machine. Make sure to like, subscribe, and hit the bell icon so you don't miss out on our videos coming out every week, Sunday at 8 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. Or daylight time. I don't know. One of the times. 8 o'clock. Check your watch. With this Onefinity machine, you can make unique and one-of-a-kind gifts. So stay up to date with us and explore all the possibilities your Onefinity CNC machine provides to you. See you in the next video.